tonight. Check the radio, pit crew is far from slow. The lights no longer yellow. Ready, steady, go. Crank it up. Oh, it's racing. Crank it up. Oh. Come on, fast is the way to drive. Crowds all on their feet, not one bothered by the heat. Imagine them in the driver's seat. Checkered flag would be sweet. Crank it up, oh, it's racing. Crank it up, oh.
Ladies and gentlemen, it is my pleasure and honor to welcome to you here tonight for our action-packed racing event here tonight as we are presenting to you 13 of the best and the brightest young drivers of the Kings of Sling Racing Series here. And now it's time to steer the BeardFx late crate model late models here and now on PTM Racing TV. Hi again, everyone. I am Christian, the Crusaders driver, and welcome back to the show. As always, as we're prepared to go to battle here at Volusia Speedway, drivers getting last-minute runs around the track, getting some last-minute shots under the hood. See some awesome-looking designs here. You'll see much of that here tonight. As you see that 122 there, Ryan Lambie, right now trying to rock a little BeardFx on that hood there. Got about a couple more seconds left here in open qualifying. That will end it out. So now, as we get ready to go here, the time has settled. The time has come, race fans. It's time for the Kings of Sling. And it is time indeed here, race fans. Here we go. Let's start it up with our first race of the night. Heat number one coming your way here on the pole. We're going to see that is the number 93. That is Kyle Dersherm. And as outside, that'll be Shane Greco in the 33. Row number two, it's going to be J.C. Tyler Cox in the 68. Row number outside of him will be Cole Shoemaker, excuse me, in the 027. Row number three is going to be Jeremy Chris there in the 21 is outside. Jonah Perkins in number six. Final starter here in this one, John Blake, the 77, with Eric Tupper in the 115 is outside. And if I did mess your name up here tonight, guys, feel free to come at me. I know I said JC, it's J.E. Tyler Cox. My apologies there. So here we go. We're ready to get this one fielded in here tonight, presented in part by BeardFx Gaming here. Late crate models now rocking and rolling, ready to strive and shuck and dive here. The Motors running, the cars are hot, the cars are heated, they're ready for you fans here to come on board and watch some action here. We'll take three into this one. Three transfer in, the rest will have to fight it out in the consolations. 10 laps shit out here in the first event, right out of the gate. Shane Greco, the number 93, the number 33, while Kyle Dershem will be the 93 there on the inside. That is the starter. He tells the drivers, we're going to start it up my way, mohow, no way, no shape and form. We're going to give it all we got. And if you do not follow my cue, you will not be, you'll be left in the dust, my friend. Kings of Slings lead coming on board saying, good luck, guys. Smallest field of the series this year. It may be small on field, my friends, but that doesn't mean they can't put up a fight. We've seen here small fields can make for the best kind of races around these parts. We'll travel them down the back straightaway this time by as we presented here live on Facebook Live. We'll broadcast to be shown on YouTube later on. They'll come off a 3 and a 4 this time around. Pace car going to come off the track. And it's time for some action here down at Volusia Speedway. Off the gun, off the start. Here we go. Right down to the corners here on turn 1 and 2 out of the gate here. It'll be a hard charge. One of our guys blinks a little bit in and out. That's Shane Greco, the 33, the 93. Kyle Dershem right now trying to move his way in. Dershem right now has got the power, got the speed under the hood. J.E. Tyler Cox, so not too far off as he sneaks his way across the inside of the 33. Shane Greco losing a lot of ground there. Transfer spot being put into crisis here as Jeremy Crest looks to make a little bit of a run for it. They go right there side by side down and forward. A little bumping and banging. Rubbins racing, my friends. The 6J, that was Jonah Perkins getting connected in between there with the 27 and Cole Shoemaker. Shoemaker doing a great job though, keeping the car online, keeping the car at bay as the 6J now rockets his way into the field. Oh, he's a hard charger. He says, I don't wait around for nobody. I want the front and I want it now. He's right now rocking it in third place. Has the transfer spot locked in with 5 laps to go. Kyle Dershem right now, your race leader. The rest of the field either trying to find openings where they can or find strikes where they can get it most. In the track right now, we're on board here with Mr. Jeremy Crisp. Crisp right now trying to hold the line down as the 33 marches his way back onto the bottom, getting a run off him. Greco trying to get into this run, trying to get a charge off. You can see him now pirouetting his way on the back straightaway, getting a little more speed to Jonah Perkins. Perkins trying to hold him off. Well, he comes off of turn 3 into 4. Now Perkins with the advantage still has a run coming from him. 3 laps to go here and he number one. So far so good as the 6J continues to hold the line, hold the field. He's listening to a little bit of Toto down there because he is listening to that song you all know and love. And no, it's not Africa. Don't even come at me for that one. Coming out of turn 2 though, it is the 93 of Kyle Dershem still with the race lead. He's got this one dialed and booked in for a white flag appearance. He says, I want the final straw. I want the final leg of this one. That to be in victory lane on the start. J.E. Tyler Cox will have a little bit of work to do in the A main, while Kyle Dershem, a solid performance here in heat number one, will rocket his way into the mains. Second, we'll go to J.E. Tyler Cox. Third to Jonah Perkins. Shane Greco, fourth. Fifth, going to Jeremy Chris in the 21, rounding out your field here in heat number one. And speaking of heat number one, let's take a look at our heat results now popping up on your screen, presented in part by BeardFx Gaming here tonight. So the Crate Late Models here pulling off a great show out of the gate. Dershem wins this one. Second going to Tyler Cox. Third to Jonah Perkins. Fourth to Shane Greco. Fifth to Jeremy Chris. Sixth to Cole Shoemaker. Seventh goes to John Blake. Eighth to Eric Tupper. Rounding out your field in this first heat. Heat number two is now coming up here on your screen here. Dawson Hickens will be in the 27. It is outside. That'll be Robert Tucker in the number 5. Row number 2, it's Chad Marshall in the 44. It is outside. Ryan Lambie in the 122. Row number 3, it is Matthew Montague in the number 7. It is outside. Anthony Karf in the number 90. Final starter, that'll be B. Yams, the 37. It looks like B. Yams will not make the call here for the heat number 2, so looks like we will just have these field of drivers coming in. And already it looks like the glitch graphic gremlins are trying to disrupt the balance here tonight. See if maybe that fixed up our little trouble. And there we go. We got it all fixed. Usually I put the technical difficulty screen up, but I thought might as well just do the instant replay tonight. Brian Gunderson coming on board here tonight. Brandon Yamrick saying this guy, LOL. Yeah, that sounds about right. Remember guys, if you're going to comment in the chat as well, please do keep it a little bit civil. Don't go a little all over the place. We do ask that around here on PTM Race TV. I know the boys will be boys. They just want to have a little fun out there, that's for sure. Nathan Barbarina coming on board. Coming on. It's a good night here. It's good to have you on board, sir. So here we go, field ready to stretch them on in, get ready for the run, get ready for the cornering off. Charge them off the corners here, fight them on down, and it's green flag racing here. Off the ends we go here onto the back straightaway, every driver looking for their openings, looking for their chances where they can. Pretty solid start here for the most part, coming through, looks like everything looking okay. And we keep it going though as the field starts to sway off a little bit. We had a little bit of a problem down there. Unfortunately, the number seven is Matthew Montague. Getting kind of caught up in the mix of things. Chad Marshall as well. Dawson Hickens will be able to keep ahead as the 27 has a little bit of an opening. While the number five, or excuse me, 17, Robert Tucker, really not rocking the same number that he is on with that scheme here tonight. I'm getting word as well here from my control end. We maybe have some frame rate drops here tonight. Something has gone wrong, unfortunately. If they do continue to persist, folks, we will replay the broadcast here. Of course, tomorrow night we'll make sure everything gets taken care of. We do not want to have any of these streams not presented in their full entirety. So do not worry if you cannot see some of the action. We will get that fixed up immediately for you. Coming down the back straightaway, though, Robert Tucker having a little bit of a battle here with Dawson Hickens. The number 27 trying to hold the 17 back as they continue to march their way across the field. Moving their way in, battle for the race lead still. Hickens still holding off Tucker. Tucker looking for opportunity where he can. Ryan Lambie also in the hunt, in the fight. Anthony Carr from the number 90 trying to build momentum back up to the front. Right now Lambie currently in the hot spot with that 122 for that last spot as we go to the white flag now. 27 to Dawson Hickens and Robert Tucker each having their own field advantage. The bottom line seems to be the key play still for Tucker, and he's going to try to set it with a 17 straight in through turn 3 and 4. Side by side for the race lead. Heat number 2 will go to Dawson Hickens. Hickens managing to walk away with that one. A strong showing from him. Bit of a wild race end for him. Man, he had to really charge off that one quickly. And that will all but do it for our heats here. So we're going to go into a little warm-up session. So before we get to our warm-up session, let's take a look at our heat results right now. So looks like we're just going to get all drivers in the field. No constellations tonight, it appears. Dawson Hickens wins this one. Second going to Robert Tucker. Third will go to Ryan Lambie. Fourth to Anthony Carr. Fifth to Matthew Montague. Sixth goes to Chad Marshall. And BEMs will be the final starter there. Warm-up session is in play. We'll give them a couple minutes to go ahead and get everything all suited up and figured out, and I'm gonna go down there and try to figure out what happened to our frame rates here. Alright, so I think what happened was, folks, is we may have had a power outage here down at Volusia Speedway out of the gate. We usually, if you, anybody that knows us broadcasting around here knows us all too well, we never have this kind of bad problems or technical difficulties like this generally. We've always been pretty, we've always had pretty good times, pretty good momentum, pretty good opportunities to show and showcase the best and the best and make sure that you are only presented with the clearest of racing and procedures. But it seems as though tonight the Glitch Graphic Gremlins have decided otherwise. They're like, eh, we heard you there, so why don't we make it a little bit of a harder night for you? And apparently they did, but it looks like everything's working okay on my end here. You guys let me know down in the chat in the comments section. Everything looking okay on your end and looking good? Hopefully we'll be able to get a little bit more showcasing in between here. Looks like a little bit of trouble though there with the 21 of Jeremy Chris, as he'll have to back her down and get it put into pit road. Hopefully get cleaned up a little bit. We saw some great battles there in the first couple heats. Some great racing in between. And a lot of drivers really firing all in all cylinders, looking for any opportunity they can. Yeah, Crawford saying everything good here, buddy. Good to know there, my friend. We just had him on a little while ago. So at least we would know for sure the A main will look pretty solidly here. Looking like it may be a good shine for a good show here tonight. Again, for those that kind of may have missed something in the heats there, again, apologies there. We did not expect that stuff to happen. We don't want none of that nonsense around here. We only want to make sure these are good to go and ready for action play. So with 15 drivers here tonight looking to showcase their action, showcase their expertise of the late models. Remember, these are drivers that are running on a very specifically designed car. They're actually designed as an open setup kind of vehicle, kind of tool to use. They're probably wondering, oh, okay, what does that mean exactly? Well, open setups means you can basically go in, you can tinker with the setups, you can tinker with the tires, tinker with the shock absorbers. Instead of just doing offset and ratio, you basically get free will to do anything you want with the whole setup of the car, which can allow for multiple angles, multiple lines on, depending on how your driving style is. Some like to go to the bottom, some may want to go to the top side. It all depends on your way and your racing abilities. And that's exactly what these drivers are going to be trying to plan out to do and to give themselves a show for you here. Final seconds here, pulling off here, which means now it is that time, ladies and gentlemen. It is that moment we all come to see, we all wait to present to you here and now. It is that time we're going to get settled in as we get the music ready, get the blood pumping. The action has only just begun. Now we present to you the A main event here tonight. Start him up on the pole. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Jonah Perkins, the number 6, is outside Robert Tucker, the number 5. Row number 2, J.E. Tyler Cox, the 68, is outside. That'll be Dawson Hickens in the 27. Row number 3 is going to be Kyle Drachem in the 93, is outside Bryant Lambie in the 122. Row number 4, Shane Greco, the 33, is outside. That's Anthony Karp in the number 90. Row number 5, it's going to be Jeremy Christ in the 21, is outside Matthew Montague in the number 7. Final starters in row 6, Cole Shoemaker in the 027, is outside. That'll be Chad Marshall, the 44. Then we will see John Blake in the 77 with B. Gant in the 37 and Eric Tupper in the 115. Race fans, you come for a show, you come for the action. There is only one place to get it from. There is only one spot to truly catch it from. And that is right here off PTM Racing TV. We present to you live here and now the Kings of Sling. It's time for the BeardFx Gaming Late Great Models. Fielding them around off of 3 and 4. One more time, Barb. This is hooray lap time. These drivers want it here. Everyone is ready to go, ready to feel this one in. Catching all the action, catching all the momentum in the charge at hand. This is where you make your name for yourselves. This is where some of the greats that have ever raced on the tracks of iRacing, on NASCAR Heat or any kind of racing for that matter, have come to. They travel down from far reaches to settle in and get showcased on PTM Racing TV, and we're about to see it here and now as they bring the green flag out. It's go time for the Kings of Sling. We'll march them down off of turn 2 here out of the gate on the back straightaway. The 27, Dawson Hickens, looking for an early run here as he's got a little bit of company right behind him with Robert Tucker and the number 17. Down across the front straightaway here, still side by side as they battle it out. Kyle Drachem looking pretty strong there on the bottom line. Looking to try to see if he can sneak his way around the corners here into the fight, into the zone. Every driver for themselves. You don't make it without breaking a few things around here. And right now the only thing that's breaking is that track, because you can see the slicks and the rubber start to be paved away. That will make drivers forced either to move or go to the top side if they have to. Jonah Perkins, the number 6J, he's a bad man right now. The fast cat is currently hammering down and showing everybody who is the boss. Continuing to charge and continuing to make the run for it here. Nobody driving it quicker and harder than that man, but maybe one in the 68, Tyler Cox. Might I add, earlier on, I was reminded he is one of the toughest drivers to beat right now and maybe one of the guys to watch out for throughout this event. He's going in tonight with a streak, and he said to me earlier today, I wish to continue the streak and win it out more as we go. Well, to do so, you have to try to knock down the best on a track like this. Volusia Speedway has been known to have some incredible races before. And we're seeing it here and now as currently everybody's still in a standstill in a fight and around the track. Ryan Lambie there, the 122, going at it right here with the 21. That's Jeremy Chris right in front of him as we're taking the onboard camera. And they can hear the roar of the motor and the RPMs just screaming around the straightaways and around the track, on around the surface of the turns. They have to keep the RPMs high. They got to keep the momentum up so that way they can keep the corners nice and tight, nice and persistent, so that way they have runs off. It's very difficult to make a pass around here when you don't have a little bit of speed to your name. And it can be even more difficult when you got company sinking your way around as someone put the fender into my camera. Do not break my camera there, Tyler. Well, he says, okay, I won't break your camera. I'll just break the leader. He goes straight down to the bottom. He looks for a run. And the 6J says, no, sir. I will not let you by. You will have to find a better way than that. Well, I think he might have a better option here coming down the road, but will he be able to get it? 40 laps in this one. We're 1/4 of the way here as we go on board with Robert Tucker, and not the number 5, but in the number 17. Still a hard battle up for the lead here. Three cars involved here. It's Jonah Perkins, J.E. Tyre Cox, Dawson Hickens. They're all in it to win it right now. Either one of them gets an opportunity to strike, they will when it seizes it. More so for Tyre Cox and Hickens as they're starting to fall into lap traffic. Lap traffic going to be a major factor here if they're not careful. Which one of them will be able to keep the momentum alive, keep the chances at bay? Down in the corner, down out turn 1 and 2. Here we go. Tyre Cox looking to try to keep the streak alive. But the problem with Volusia is there's really one line up and there's one line down. If you can get the run on the back straight away, that's your saving grace, because you can rock the speeds going into the middle section where the bottom line may not have as much grip right out of the gate, and it can definitely challenge them up a little bit here. We're seeing that right now. You saw Tyler, he was diving down low, looking to see which way he can go. But it was not to be had. It was not giving him any chance there. 77, that's John Blake. Gonna be a little bit of lap traffic. Gonna be a little more of a nuisance as he gets right in between there. It's Tyler Cox. Has to back her down, get out of the way here. Driver's now having to fight out with lap traffic and also themselves as they get a little bit of cobbles down the front straightaway. Big wreck, we got troubles. Caution flag is out. We got trouble down there for the 44 of Chad Marshall and the 77 of John Blake, unfortunately. Bit of a wild ride there, and that was a bit of a maddening little crash around. Let's take a look at the PTM Instant Replay presented in part by tonight by BeardFx Gaming. Here's another look at it. The old mantra is, that's just hard racing, but I mean, if you look at this right here, this is kind of a bad situation to be in. That's the 77 getting clipped in, and you see even the 17 kind of got himself into a bit of a pickle there. We'll take a look at it from that angle here. John Blake at the 77, and then the 17 was, looks like that was, yep, that was actually the number 5 there. That was Mr. Robert Tucker caught up in the mix of that one there. We'll take one more look at it here as he gets kind of caught in between that little mess here. Here's an onboard camera here. Tucker just got caught off on lap traffic, and you can see a 77's got him for a ride, and everybody else is just trying to avoid him and get out of that mess. What a tough break there for the drivers, but everybody seems to be okay, and everything seems to be all right on their end. We'll see just how much damage they suffered, though, in that little wreck and that little carnage. Also tonight, folks, we aren't just getting this presented by the BeardFx Gaming Crate late models of Volusia Speedway. Also RTL Ripping the Lip TV also coming on board here as well to help present the show to you guys. So thank you again to them, as well as Kings of Sling, for having us come on out and showcase these drivers for the first time ever. It's great to have you all on board. Hope you're enjoying it. And if you guys are brand new to the show, please be sure to like, follow, and subscribe on our Facebook and our YouTube. And that's right, we actually have a YouTube end as well. You'll see this race in its entirety over there in crystal clarification here on Facebook for the YouTube as well. So no worry about that as we go back to the green flag and we're back to the action. And one nice thing for the race leaders, I guess you could say, is they don't have to worry about lap traffic, but that doesn't necessarily mean they're out of the woods yet. Matthew Montague getting caught up in the mix of things here. And look at Tyler Cox on the outside. Got a run there. The 68 managing to get to the outside quickly enough of the 6J. Jonah knows he's going to have to start pushing a little harder to get back in there. The outside is the verb. The outside is where he wants to play. 6J trying to get back down low. Look at him driving it straight down into the corners, trying to get a run up, but he just can't get the speed to carry. Takes a lot of commitment, a lot of heart to make a move off that exit and off that area, but man, he certainly has proven he can do it. It's a five-car battle for the race lead. Cox, though, is the one they're all wanting to knock down. The streak may continue on here at Volusia if he can get one more run there. Laps winding down. We're just about halfway completed this one here. The 6J at Jonah Perkins coming on to the bottom. Straight inside, can't get the slider to kick up. Tyler managing to take the lead, Morin did. And look at Shane Greco swinging the Christ up bottom of the strip. He managed to get around the 6J of Jonah Perkins for all of one little corner there. He literally sweeped that rear end so far in the front, you would have thought he literally had a mop and broom and a dustpan right there just to clean up the hood. He's like, sir, I see you have a little dirt there. Let me clean that off. Well, he certainly cleaned off that, and maybe a little more some, I would say, but hey, he got it all taken care of, I would say. Right now, Jeremy Chris goes back on board with him. He is still fighting again in the top five, looking for an opening from the drivers. Jonah looking to get back on the on the outside line, but he's kind of stuck in a rock in a hard place here, that being the bottom of Volusia on a burnt-in track surface. The hardest part about trying to move your way from any track in here is the fact that you're also struggling to find and maintain grip and maintain balance. Speed is crucial here. And you're seeing that and then some here. We're currently down to the final 16 laps. Perkins now back in the zone, back in the run. Look at the back of the pack here. And you can see the five, Robert Tucker, despite the little trouble he had a minute ago, seems to be back on the grip of things and starting to figure this one up more. The 122, Ryan Lambry still hunts him down. Chad Marshall, that 44, is going to try and hope for the best, I would say. Looking for any opportunity he can, so we take it to the onboard camera. And in the back of the pack here, the 27, Cole Shoemaker. Not really the night I think he was looking for, neither for Matthew Monaghan. You saw a little bit at the start, he was getting all over the place, getting cross-eyed and cross-shaped and cross-footed in turn one and two, but he managed to bring it back down and save it up a bit. Firing them off around the corners here. Your battle is currently for the fifth place spot and fourth, if you will, because Jonah Oh, no! I was going to say it was a battle for fourth, but it looks like John Blake yet again getting caught in the mix of problems and territory zone. And that left side is bent in a little bit. That's one thing you got to love about the physics around here. They look absolutely tremendous on the damage model these days. But unfortunately, John Blake, I don't think, was expecting this little nonsense here. Let's take a look at the PTM Instant Replay. Boy, watch this. You can see the 6J just kind of drifted up. He got the corner end of the wall, and I don't believe Jonah by any means was hoping for that to happen. But, I mean, at the end of the day, it's just a tough, tough break. So the field, after all that madness, all that craziness now, gonna try to double him up. And for Tyler Cox, I gotta believe this is probably the worst opportunity for him. He now knows he's a bit in trouble because that bottom line is not where he wants to be at. He wants to go to the outside again and try to charge off that. Question is, will he be able to? That's kind of a no man's land spot right now, considering what they're driving up against and what they're dealing with right at the moment. We'll see, though, as he gets the car swinging around. He's trying to warm up the tires. He wants to warm up, or as one fella told me one time, he's trying to tune up the band like old HB Shizzle down there. He wants to make sure he's got some sweet chin music to lay down on the boys. But in order to do so, Shane Greco in that 33 will have no qualms about making a move off him. Coming off around, though, out of turn three into four, and it's back to the green flag here, and Cox manages to get a good runoff on the start with the hole shot. Oh, but right down the inside, here comes Garrett Greco right on the battle. Right on the money, right on the mark, but it's not enough. Cox managing to stay ahead. Whoa, where did the 6J come from? Huge slider coming out of three and four. Holy cow, this cat does not give an inch, and one right back at him from the 21 of Jeremy Chris. Nearly banging the wall around here. These guys in the back are throwing haymakers like Mike Tyson to Vander Holyfield all of a sudden. This is getting good. This is getting interesting here. Which one will make, which one blinks first? Oh, looks like that might be the 17 of Robert Tucker. Or maybe not. Kyle Dersham gets a little bit in trouble there coming off of turn two. Smacks the wall protection a little bit, trying to back her down and get settled back down with eight laps to go. Chad Marshall, the 44, right in the mix of this here, trying to hammer it in again, give himself a little bit of breathing room to strike while the iron's hot. He wants to put the full pedal straight down into the metal and make a move up on all that come before him. He's got a chance right now. He's a hard charger. He's got five spots up. The only other ones that are five up, Jeremy Crisp and Shane Greco. They're the only other ones that are five spots in. Greco now running out of time, though. Looks like he might be running out of laps as well. Looking at the lap times here, this is not good if you're Greco's camp. Cox right now is currently dominating and defending everyone, and then some, five laps to go. And the times do not lie. That was another big get. Greco is in trouble. If he does not build up a little bit of a draft, a little bit of a speed booster, I don't think he's going to have time. Or you could just wait for something like this to happen. Caution's out. It's a pile up in three and four. And maybe a cleanup on I-235, unfortunately, here. What a mess and a breakdown here. That was not what Cox wanted to see or have happen, I guarantee you that much. But nevertheless, you have to see what you play, what you can work with. Here's what happened. Watch this, coming around on the back straightaway. And I'm going to be honest with you, I really can't tell if the 17 actually even got any of the 93. It looked like it was a little bit of the dreaded glitch graphic gremlins coming on board for some net code or two, but that was a hard little break there. Kyle Dersham is okay, though. He's telling me right now he's a little more miffed than anything had happened, but he's all right. All right. Feel ready to get back down to business, back down to the action here, and boy, it has been a wild one, that is for sure, but we still have a race to finish, and I don't think it can get any bigger than this one right now. Tyler E. Cox, your race leader. The number 68, now it's going to be a single file line here that they're going to have to work off of. That could very well play into Cox's advantage. Greco, Hickens, Chris, and Perkins are going to have a little bit of work to do here. They're going to have to start sending them in a little harder if they can catch around him. Cox knows he's going to have to build all the momentum and make sure it's his way or the highway. And Greco caught him on the draft, looking for the charge off. They get the whole shot once again. The green flag we go. That was a solid run off of the corners here as Jonah once more starts to just sneak his way around. Shoemaker going out a little bit here with Mr. Lambie in the number 122. Feel stressed out. Everybody still in this to win it, obviously. There has no gimmies here. And right now, Tyler Cox trying to hold down Greco. Greco looking for the opening. We're going to have two laps remain. This time by, the green flag will fly high in the air. And that means one thing. They are knowing it. There is two to go. Cox has been bad fast. He's been smart all day long, and he wants one more shot at it. Out of three and four to the white flag we go. Hickens, Greco, and Cox trying to hammer down, get one last shot at this one. Cox, though, out of the back straightaway. You might as well say the streak continues on and lives for another day. Tyler Cox will win Volusia. And it certainly was a battle here. The caution flags working more in his favor than anything else I say for that first one, but maybe not so much after that. But the speed he carried, just enough. He is your winner here at Volusia Speedway, race fans. There he is now, the 68. Give it up for J.E. Tyler Cox. And everybody going down there to park him up a little bit. It's a beautiful sight to always see those top three drivers coming in for a little showcase here. And it looks like we are ready to go ahead and head it back down here. Race fans, let's go ahead and have a word in with our top three here tonight. We'll start him up with the 27 here. He'll join me down here in pit road as he hops out of the car real quick here. Dawson, congratulations on a third place finish, my friend. You certainly had a lot of work to do with the company and the drivers that you're facing up against. But tell me, how was those restarts and really what was the hardest part about just trying to make a pass here at Volusia?
You know, it was pretty one lane, and I felt pretty good at the start of the race, and then that first caution kind of screwed me, and I got back to like fifth, and just kind of had to pick your place and make a move and be smart about it and not lose all your momentum.
Obviously, you didn't quite lose all the momentum, but still just couldn't get enough of it to get around Cox or Greco to the end. But nevertheless, you're still having a great showing here in third for Volusia. Is there anybody you want to thank here for tonight for this finish, my friend?
Yeah, I'd like to thank the Farm Service Co-op, Hike Construction, and the Dig Gang with Jeremy, Shane, and Tyler. We've all been working together, and we're all up there in points and been running real good this season.
Absolutely, indeed. Well, nevertheless, here, obviously, the points race continues to be strong and hard, but nevertheless, you guys are right there with them. So congratulations on your third-place finish here tonight, and we certainly hope to see you back here on PTM Racing TV, sir.
Sounds good. Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, the number 27, that is Dawson Hickens, and machine here. We'll talk now with our second place finisher here tonight. He comes to you here in the number 33. Ladies and gentlemen, give it up for Shane Greco. And Shane, as you hop out of that late model here and kind of looking at the scene of the crime here, man, looked like Cox kind of left everybody high and dry and left them for dead. But, man, you were still on the case and you were hot on his trail, but just wasn't enough. You didn't have enough laps there. What happened?
Yeah, man, I battled internet connection issues there, and he just dropped to the back. I didn't want to cause nobody to wreck. I tried to get that issue straight. I don't think I ever did, but had to start far back. And I don't know, man. He's tough. You know, it's hard to beat him. He does it a lot, just like I do. But just one of those things.
It is definitely one of those things. But I mean, I know if one thing that's for sure is you live and learn and figure out how to get better at it than anything. What is there anything really you'd be able to take away from tonight that you can use for later on in this case?
Not really. I mean, I don't really like Volusia anyway. It's, you know, I'm actually surprised I ran this good here anyway, man. It's a tough track for me. Just glad to get a solid finish.
Well, I mean,
head on next week.
Well, I mean, it's even better then. I mean, you got a second place finish at Volusia, a track you're not too fond of. I mean, hey, that's got to mean something. So I guess if that ends up being this way, I got to ask you, is there anybody you want to thank you for the second place finish here tonight?
Yeah, absolutely. We got quite a few sponsors, Meineke, Jackson Equipment, Travelers Pharmacy, Grassroots Sports TV. Too many to name. OCV, FK Rodians, all kinds. Wanted to shout out to the Dig Gang. We had a solid top three finish there. Me, Tyler, and Dawson there. We tried to get on a little hour earlier or so and tune on these cars and try to get better.
And you certainly did tune them up just enough for a second place finish. So, Shane, congratulations tonight, and we certainly hope to see you back here as well, my friend.
Yes, sir. I'll be there.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, give it up for your second place finisher here tonight. That being Shane Greco, the number 33. All right, and finally, race fans, the streak continues. Your race winner, Tyler Cox, as he joins me here in victory lane here at Volusia Speedway. Tyler, you've had a strong showing and a strong racing season so far, and week by week basis, man, you just seem to come out bigger and badder than ever. What in the heck is your secret that no one else is able to figure out?
It's just that the car's good right now. You know, we tune on these setups and try to do a little bit of practice before the races, and we just, all three of us really got the cars good right now, so we just fine tuning them and hopefully stay up front
for sure there. With all that's been transpired and everything that's gone through this race here, was any time tonight you felt like maybe you could be a little bit in trouble, or could be some heavy hitters coming your way to fight it out there and try and knock you off that podium.
The only thing that really worried me, you know, the track there was kind of okay at the beginning on the bottom, and I could get up beside Jonah, but I was afraid if I didn't clear him quick enough and get up back up into the groove that I was going to get freight trained. So kind of rolled back off of him one lap and got a big run and cleared him there, and it all worked out, and that was fun.
It was indeed fun to call, fun to watch, and my friend, now you are coming away with another victory, another race trilogy to end out this week. Who do you want to thank here tonight for this victory?
Just Cox Properties, All Star Services, Dig Gang. Like I said, we just do this for fun. We race in real life, but we do this in the evenings when there ain't nothing else to do. So that's about it. And just as a group together, you know, Jeremy and Dawson and Shane, it's we just put our heads together and try to make some setups that's fast.
Absolutely, and not having to worry about spending too much money out there on the track, I would say, or to get to it. So, nevertheless, Tyler, appreciate coming on board here tonight. Congratulations on your race win, man.
Alrighty, man. Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, your race winner here tonight at Volusia Speedway. Give it up for J.E. Tyler Cox, the number 68. And race fans, that's all going to do it here tonight. We'll show you our final feature winners here tonight in this one. This is your final results for the whole season, or not whole season, for the day anyway. But it has been my honor and my pleasure to call it here on PTM Racing TV. Again, for those that were on the Facebook Live end, I do very much apologize for the second heat, I believe, or the first heat, whichever one it was, where the glitch graphic gremlins came on the attack. Hopefully we do not ever have to hear about that ever again, and it does not happen again here on the show. But, you know, that's the kind of thing with live television sometimes. It can get you, so... But nevertheless, appreciate you guys tuning on board here, and we certainly hope you will join us again. From all of us here at PTM Racing TV, thank you for coming out tonight, and we'll see you again next time when the green flag flies right here on PTM Racing TV.